Consider this picture being shown on the screen. Here, we have placed an object, that is a candle, in front of a concave mirror. Now, since we have placed the object in front of the concave mirror, we will obtain an image. As you can see, the image has been obtained on a screen that has been placed behind the object. Now, if we have to find out the focal length of this concave mirror through this experimental setup, can you tell me how it can be found? We are going to find out how, with the help of this experimental setup, we can find out the focal length of the concave mirror. Before we go into the details of finding the focal length, let us find out what the Cartesian coordinate system states. In a Cartesian coordinate system, there are two axes to map a point in two-dimensional space. The horizontal axis is known as the x-axis, and the vertical axis is known as the y-axis. The point at where the x-axis and y-axis meets is known as the origin. As you can see, all points on the x-axis that lie to the left of the origin is considered as negative, and all points that lie on the right of the origin on the x-axis is considered positive. Similarly, all points that lie above the origin on the y-axis is considered positive, and all points that lie below the origin on the y-axis are considered negative. So how can we translate the Cartesian coordinate system in case of spherical mirrors? Here we see a concave mirror. In the case of a concave mirror, the pole of the concave mirror is considered as the origin. Points to the left, that is, points on the principal axis that is taken as the x-axis, are considered as negative. And points to the right of the origin are considered as positive. That is, points on the principal axis or the x-axis. So what happens in the case of a convex mirror? In case of a convex mirror also, the pole is considered as the origin and the principal axis is considered as the x-axis. Here, all points to the left are measured as negative, to the left of the origin, and all points to the left, to the right of the origin, or the right of the pole, are measured as positive. Now, as I just mentioned, all distances that are measured towards the left of the origin or the pole are negative. And all distances that are measured towards the right of the pole or the origin are positive. The same holds true for a convex mirror. All distances towards the left are negative, and all distances towards the right are measured as positive. Now, as you know, in all experimental setups, the object is always placed to the left or in front of the mirror. So in this case, the object on the principal axis is placed to the left of the mirror or to the left of the origin. So the object distance is measured towards the left of the origin. So this will be measured as negative. Similarly, in case of a convex mirror, since the object is placed to the left of the origin in front of the convex mirror, the distance of the object will be measured as negative. Now consider what happens if we take distances that are above or below the principal axis. Now as we learned, in a Cartesian coordinate system, points that are above the origin on the y-axis are taken as positive. So in this case, any distance or height that is measured above the principal axis is taken as positive. Similarly, as in the Cartesian coordinate system, any point on the y-axis that lied below the origin was taken as negative, In this case also, points lying below the principal axis are measured as negative. That is, distances or heights below the principal axis are measured as negative. Similarly, in case of a convex mirror, distances or heights above the principal axis are positive. Distances or heights below the principal axis are negative. So, in case of a concave mirror, when we keep an object on the principal axis in front, the object height is measured as positive. And as you know, in case of a concave mirror, when a real image is formed, the image is always inverted. That is, it lies below the principal axis. So the image height is considered as negative. In case of a convex mirror, similarly, we consider heights measured above the principal axis as positive and heights below the principal axis as negative. So, with all this information, how can we find out the focal length of a mirror? The focal length of a mirror is found out with the help of the mirror formula. Note that this mirror formula holds true for all spherical mirrors. What does the mirror formula state? The mirror formula states that 1 by V plus 1 by U equals 1 by F. Here, U is the object distance, V is the image distance, and F is the focal length of the spherical mirror that we want to find out. So, how can we simplify this expression to obtain the focal length? This formula, as we saw, was the mirror formula. So, if we take the LCM of the left-hand side, we get the following expression. If we further simplify this, we'll see that the focal length of the mirror comes out to be U times V divided by V plus U. That is, the focal length of the mirror is given by object distance times image distance divided by the sum of object and image distance. Now we have performed an experiment with a concave mirror and the candle. In the experiment, we have placed the candle at varying distances from the mirror. At first, we have placed the candle or the object at a distance of 45 centimeters from the candle. And the image that we obtained was obtained at a distance of 22 centimeters in front of the mirror. We repeated this experiment for two more positions of the candle. At 40 centimeters of the object, we obtained the image at 24 centimeters in front of the mirror. And when the object was placed 50 centimeters from the mirror, we obtained the image at 22.04 centimeters. So with this information, can we find out the focal length? Let us see. First, we consider the first set of readings, that is, object distance 45 centimeters and image distance 22 centimeters. Now you will recall, in case of a concave mirror, since the object is kept on the left side of the origin or in front of the mirror, it is considered as negative. Also, since the image is formed on the same side as that of the object, the image distance is also negative. So if we put these values in the mirror formula, let us see what we get. As we learnt that the distance towards left is measured negative and distance towards the right is measured as positive. So when we place the values, we see that 1 upon minus 45, that is the object distance, plus 1 upon minus 22, that is the image distance, equals 1 upon F. This is the mirror formula. Now, if we simplify this by taking the LCM, we get so, if we simplify the expression, we find that the focal length of the mirror comes out to be minus 14.77 centimeters. Or in other words, the focus lies in front of the concave mirror on the left of the origin or the pole. Now, if we repeat the same procedure for the other two sets of readings and use the mirror formula, we find that the focal length is obtained as 15 centimeters and 15.3 centimeters, all negative. So, from all these three sets of readings, we have obtained the focal length as minus 14.77 centimeters, minus 15 centimeters, and minus 15.3 centimeters. So, from these three, how can we find out the focal length of the concave mirror? Very simple. All we need to do is take an average of these three readings. So by taking an average of these three readings, that is minus 14.77, minus 15, and minus 15.3, we find that we get the focal length as minus 15.02 centimeters. So the focus of the concave mirror is placed at the left side of the mirror at a distance of 15.02 centimeters. Or in other words, it lies to the left side of the origin or the pole of the concave mirror in front of it. So taking a quick recap, what did we learn today? We learned that the focal length of a mirror can be found out with the help of the mirror formula. The mirror formula stated 1 by V plus 1 by U equals 1 by F. We also learned about the Cartesian coordinate system. All distances measured towards the left of the origin were negative, and all distance measured towards the right of the origin were positive on the x-axis. Similarly, all distances measured above the origin were positive, and all distances or heights measured below the origin were negative on the y-axis. When we translated the same thing in the case of spherical mirrors, we found that all distances to the left of the pole were negative, and all distances to the right of the pole were positive. Likewise, all heights measured above the principal axis were positive, and all heights measured below the principal axis were negative.